Hey guys, I am Shauna Wise. Welcome to Technically Cooking, and today we are invited out to a local beekeeper's farm, and they are going to show you where your honey comes from. And it just pushes them down inside the hive, and it doesn't hurt them? Or
doesn't hurt them. Hear them?
I do hear them. And if I just stand here, he will just crawl up my shirt. So, oh, that's cool. Approximately how many trays are in each hive?
There's 10 frames in each one of the layers.
Okay. And you leave so many in each one for them to eat for the winter?
Yeah. Mainly these bottom two for the queen to lay eggs in.
Okay.
And then keep honey for the winter. And then the shorter ones is the honey we collect.
Okay. So a couple of fun facts about honey that you may not know is honey is one of those products that don't go bad unless they get water in them and then they ferment, so honey can last for years. The other thing about honey is it's also a natural antibiotic, so it's great for cuts and burns, just to help the healing process. You can also make hand lotions and wax, candles, and lip balm out of the wax that's used and recycled from this. Ooh. That's pretty cool. That's cool.
Gotta find a brush to brush them off.
And approximately how many bees do you have?
Well, there's four hives, 30 to 50,000 in each hive.
Oh, wow. And then you'll scrape it off and stick it in an extractor, or?
I can make a centrifuge. It'll sit and spin.
Okay. And does that separate out the wax?
It runs through a couple filters once it's spun out.
Okay.
It pulls out any wax or beads or junk.
That's next.
I guess when I leave it,
hi guys.
See any on this one?
the grandkids get to come and see how honey's made too. Super cool. I'm excited to get to do this.
I think you took two out of this one last time,
carrying the honey box. Going to get some more of these. Ah, there's that.
You got a stinger out. This is a hive's a little unfriendly.
Oh, this one is? Mm-mm. They're just protecting their food source.
Yep.
Ooh. It's a little windy today. And do you collect honey, what, 3 times a year? Maybe, depends upon.
This is the third time.
Okay.
Depends on the year.
So for technically cooking, some other fun facts is my son uses honey in his coffee every day, and I use honey to make simple syrups, glazes, and use it as a sugar alternative in many recipes. Oh. No. You never been stung? I had one crawling up my shirt over there, and I'm like, it's nice in the sun, but when you get in the shade, it's a little breezy. Oh, wow.
This is the brood. The queen's probably around in here somewhere. And on down, they even got more on them.
These cells in the middle here that are covered. Or actually bees. This is where she's laid eggs at. And they're about to hatch. There's a couple getting ready to come out now.
Cool.
You might want to back up.
That's awesome. That'd have been great if I had tripped and fell backwards. That's what they'll eat off of first, is the frames you've already extracted from?
Yeah, then I put a honey collected, put it back in another cell.
Okay.
We woke them up, didn't we?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to stand over here in the sunlight. And I'm always cold, so it's kind of funny I don't have a jacket on. Just wax. Oh, wow. There's a lot on that one. One on this back side. Don't want to be on the video. Oh, come on, Christian. My bamboo plants have been covered in bees right now.
Yeah, but they're eating here too.
Well, I didn't look until you showed me or told me the other day, so.
Sun is on And most bees can't get in through that suit.
Yeah, they can't go through there. It's three layers.
Oh, okay.
Hmm.
Do they extract it in there?
Mm-hmm. Cap it, and then they'll put it in the spinny.
Okay. So now we get to see how it's extracted. Does it?
Yes. Mesh with a layer that's thick enough they can't get their stinger clear through.
Huh. So what is this?
This is the extractor. Put the frames in it after we cut the caps off.
Okay.
And spin them. And the honey all goes flying out the sides. It's just a big centrifuge.
Cool.
Here's skinny arms.
Yep.
Up the bottom.
Why me?
You got the skinny arms.
And then it filters it?
Okay. Wax or beef hearts or bees or...
Gotcha. Doug said he didn't notice a big flavor difference between the dark honey or the light honey.
What's
this machine do?
That's
the
one
you
used to
do.
Yeah,
oh.
He's in the window.
This is a pop-up. Oh, you pour it in the top and... What is that, a scraper? Like, is it hot?
Yeah, heat up scraper, melts the caps.
Okay.
Like right here where they got the comb all closed off, which is full of honey. This will cut that cap, that wax right off, and let that honey come out when it spins.
Oh, cool.
And it goes through this decapping tank. Catches the wax caps and lets the honey go through. It doesn't make it much brighter, does it?
Huh?
Last time.
I think last time I got three bottles.
There's only three bottles in there.
Hmm.
That's right from the bee.
Yep. Thank you. How many trays fit in there?
Six.
Okay. So the wax that's left, could you use that like making jams and jellies for your wax on top?
Or lip balm or things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Beeswax, anything beeswax.
Instead of paraffin wax, I was thinking of honey wax since you already have it. Top. Yep.
Everything will be sticky till we're done. Get a B on that one.
Yeah, you
know, maybe. No, you're not gonna do well.
And it just comes out?
Yeah. Yeah. After it gets stirred, if you look down in there, you'll see it throwing against the sides.
Oh, yep.
Obviously, they're not balanced, so you got to hold them where it starts walking away.
The worst part.
What?
Standing
there. Oh, because of the rock? And then it'll come out over here.
Eventually, it takes a while.
Okay.
We'll let you know.
Well, it'll start coming out the bottom, will it not? No.
Yeah, you'll know.
So this is how women feel about the wash machine.
It'll take most of these frames to fill up the bottom so it runs out.
Okay.
Oh, they found us on the outside of the window. Mm-hmm. The bees can smell the honey.
They want it back. Oh, wow. Yep. They found the honey. Yeah. They want it back. Oh, my stars. That's a lot.
That's what it looks like when I wash the stuff up outside, too.
Oh, because they want it back out of there, too?
And they go after anything sweet.
I'm in trouble.
Burn smell.
Good.
Tastes like honey.
Yep. When it comes out in a big glob, is that the wax? Some other wax that comes out with it, and so the filter catches it?
Yep, one of those two filters.
Gotcha. That's cool. It's lighter than what I thought it was going to be.
Looks lighter.
And honey is sold by the pound? I'm gonna go out and check out those bees. So the bees know that they're extracting the honey, and they are on the outside here. They can smell it. Do you see them all up against the house?